Before starting the explanation of the export of the list of plugins, I would like to thank 3 followers who sent me their contribution as they were happy with the tutorials of this channel. In chronological order, they are Believable Audio, Matteo Nolli, Enrico Ornielli. Thank you so much, friends. I really appreciate your gesture. On this episode, I want to show you how to export the list of all plugins installed in Reaper. It is useful for having an archive of all VST, VSTIs, but also AU and LV2, in case you need to transfer everything to another machine, a migration, you know exactly what to reinstall. Let's see how to do it. Install my Reapack library, above in the description the video on how to do it. Having done this, mouse over extensions, Reapack, browse packages and search for my name. The list of all my scripts appears there accordingly. The script you are interested in is a utility and it's called Export VSTs, VSTIs, AUs, data in CSV and HTML formats. Select it, right-click. There are also other older versions, but I recommend the latest one in time, as it has bugs fixed and additional functions. Then install, then click on Apply. Wait for it to be installed, click on OK. From now on, you have it on your machine, and you won't have to do it again. Go to Actions, Show Actions List, and search for my name. The script appears there. Here it is. You can also assign it to a button on the control bar. To learn how, watch the video above in the description. Now click on Run or on Run Close, the script is executed. In Reaper's parent directory, which is where the Reaper executable is located, 2 files are formed, one HTML and the other one is a CSV. You can open the latter with Excel, as you can see here, and it contains the list of all installed plugins. This Reaper installation is the portable one and has only default VSTs. Using the Excel functions, you can filter them as you wish and use this file as a working file. But the HTML file is more user-friendly. It opens with any browser, just double-click. A common area appears on the left side and the list of all plugins on the right side. The first column contains some boxes that you will use in the way that I will tell you in seconds. The second column indicates whether the installed plugins is a musical instrument, and if it isn't, nothing appears. If it is, the right identifier shows up. The third column indicates the name of the plugin manufacturer and other indications. The fourth column is the file type. Use the mouse wheel to scroll vertically, up and down, and the header and common area remain fixed in order to facilitate operations. Here you can see the example of the installation I have in production. The column with boxes is for this. In case of migration, check the box of the plugin you have installed. Click on the Export button, check for the Reaper directory and save the JSON file in that folder. So if you close the browser or your PC crashes or you interrupt your work and resume it the next day, by opening the HTML file, the check on the boxes of reinstalled plugins is kept. When you reach a large number of reinstalled plugins, you can hide the boxes by clicking on the Hide checked button. There remain only those to be ticked that are related to the missing plugins. The same button turns its name into Show checked. By clicking it, all boxes are shown again. The Reset button removes the tick from all the checkboxes, while the How to use it button contains the instructions on how to use this list. The Open Reaper folder button shows the contents of the directory containing the Reaper executable and these files. If you found this video useful, consider joining my Patreon or pay me a beer. In both cases, here below the links in the description area. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.